If you want to fix black screen on Amazon Fire Stick, you are at the right place. We have got super ways to do that. Welcome back to Silicophilic, your go-to source for tech tips and fixes. Method 1. Change accessories. The Fire TV Stick's black screen could stem from its accessories. Check that the streaming stick is properly connected to the power adapter via a USB cable. You should also ensure that the cable's micro USB end is tightly fitted into the Fire TV Stick. Likewise, you can try using a different USB power cable and change if things are different afterwards. You must use the original USB accessories, the power adapter and cable bundled with the device. Third-party or counterfeit accessories might be unable to provide sufficient power required to boot the Fire TV Stick and keep it on for a long time. Method 2. Restart Fire TV Stick. The black screen issue could be due to a minor glitch on the streaming device. And just like other Fire TV Stick issues, simply restarting the device can help restore it to normalcy. So navigate to Settings and go to My Fire TV. Then restart your Fire TV Stick. If you're not able to access the Fire Stick Settings menu, use the remote to complete the reboot process. You can hold the Select button and the Play or Pause button together for about 5 seconds. If your remote is faulty or doesn't work, you can also unplug the Fire TV Stick from its power source and re-plug it. Upon successful reboot, play some video content on your Fire TV Stick apps and check if the visuals are playing properly or not. Method 3. Try a different HDMI port. If you are still experiencing Fire TV Stick black screen issue, check that the device is fitted completely into the TV's HDMI port. And if the TV has multiple HDMI ports, try switching the Fire TV Stick to a different port. Method 4. Use HDMI extender. Although you can plug the Fire TV Stick dongle directly into your TV, Amazon strongly recommends using the bundled HDMI extender. In addition to improving the Wi-Fi connectivity and remote performance, the extender also allows you to fit the Fire TV Stick into your TV's HDMI port properly. Method 5. Check input source. You should match your remote source or input button to the HDMI port that your Fire TV is plugged into. Setting your TV's active input source to HDMI 1 while the streaming device is connected to HDMI 2 or HDMI 3 could make you erroneously think that the TV does not recognize the Fire TV Stick and lead to a black screen. This is a common occurrence on TVs with multiple HDMI ports. Therefore, verifying that the active input source is set to the corresponding HDMI port holding the Fire TV Stick. Method 6. Check TV or port compatibility. The HDMI ports on your television set are rated to support specific resolutions and refresh rates. To use the Fire TV Stick or Fire TV Stick 4K, your TV's HDMI must be capable of handling at least full HD or HD content at 50 to 60 Hz refresh rate. Many users with a Fire TV Stick struggled using it with their HD TVs until they switched to a different TV with a 1080 pixel HDMI port. This is prevalent in old television sets. Many new generation TVs have HDMI ports that will recognize and work with all versions of the Fire TV Stick. Method 7. Update Fire OS. Once you troubleshoot Amazon Fire Stick black screen, make sure to update the Fire OS to the latest version to avoid such glitches. To do this, open Fire Stick Settings, select My Fire TV, click About, then update Fire OS from the menu. Method 8. Connect your Fire Stick directly to your TV. Connect your Fire Stick directly to your TV. If you are using any A or V receivers or soundbars, bypass them temporarily to see if they are causing the black screen. Method 9. Check your power supply. Ensure your Fire Stick is plugged into a working outlet and try using a different power adapter if you have one available. And there you have it. These 9 processes will help you to fix black screen on Amazon Fire Stick. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more tech tips and troubleshooting guides. Leave a comment and help others know about the method. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.